Welcome to part one of the Texas Medical Center Library video series on performing a literature search in PubMed. This video describes how to get started with research using basic PubMed search strategies. Start out at the Texas Medical Center Library homepage and scroll down to Core Resources. Click on the PubMed icon to open the PubMed database. The URL indicates that PubMed recognizes your affiliation with the TMC library. It's important to access PubMed via the library website so you can access full text articles available through the library's many subscription databases. Let's use the following example research question. What are the risk factors associated with childhood myeloid leukemia? Before we start searching the PubMed database, it's important to break our research topic down into main concepts. This is a good starting point for generating keyword ideas. The main concepts of this research question are myeloid leukemia, children, and risk factors. To perform a basic search in PubMed, simply type these keywords into the search bar at the top of the page. The basic search function is a good tool when you're just starting on your research project and you want to get a preliminary view of what's available in the literature. It can also help you identify synonyms for your topic and get an idea of how you might want to broaden or narrow your topic question. After entering your search terms, click the search button. To see what the database did to find you these results, click on the advanced search link and view the history. View the details of the search to see the search strategy that PubMed used. PubMed uses and or to connect search concepts. These are called Boolean operators. The Boolean operator and instructs the database to find articles that include two or more concepts together. Each time we add a concept to the formula, my results list gets smaller. The Boolean operator or instructs the database to find articles that include any concepts within a search string. The more concepts I add to the string, the more results I get. Or is used to connect synonyms or similar terms to increase the number of search results. Not tells the database to eliminate articles that use a specific term. For example, typing myeloid leukemia, not adults, will find articles dealing with myeloid leukemia, but remove any articles that mention adults. It's recommended to use this operator sparingly since it may eliminate relevant results. For example, eliminating adults from our results may also eliminate articles that mention young adults. By default, PubMed sorts results by relevancy. If you prefer to see results sorted a different way, for example, by most recent articles, click on Display Options and select the appropriate sorting option. You can also change the way articles are displayed on the page. For example, selecting Abstract displays article abstracts below each article title. Scroll through the results to look for potentially relevant articles. The free PMC icon identifies articles that are included in PubMed's free full text archive. However, limiting to full text or free full text will eliminate those articles available to you through the TMC library, so it's never a good idea to use these limiters. Click on an article title to view the full record. To open the full text of the article, click on one of the full text links on the right-hand side of the page. Since you have already been authenticated by clicking on PubMed from the library's homepage, the database automatically redirects you to the full text version of the article. Notice that the abstracts include keywords created by the authors. These words and phrases may be helpful to you when creating a bank of potential keywords for your topic. If the article has been indexed, you will see a list of MeSH terms toward the bottom of the page. MeSH stands for Medical Subject Headings. These are covered in depth in our next video. If you have questions about searching PubMed, please contact a librarian.